Hi there, welcome to the second in our art making videos. Last week you were introduced to Tom and Carmel and they're going to be working with us over the next 6 or 7 videos. So last week we looked at using bubble wrap as a printing technique and we got great feedback from people, so I hope you managed to have fun with that. And as I mentioned last week, today we're going to be looking at using watercolour pencils. And you might remember that I'd suggested that if you could get watercolour paper, that would be great. But if you haven't, don't stress about it. Just use ordinary paper. Get used to using the pencils, developing your technique, having fun. And, you know, if later you do want to see what it's like on watercolour paper, well, there'll always be an opportunity to get some later. So I really hope you enjoy this and have fun. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. My name's Tom, and I'm here with you today to do some watercolour painting with a difference. I'm using something called watercolour pencils, which a lot of people haven't heard of, though you can buy them everywhere. They're really common now. So all you need is, and it is kind of important to have watercolour paper, and I've stuck it onto the page with masking tape that gives me a border of about 1/4 inch all the way around. And with the watercolour pencils, we know they're watercolour pencils because they have this little symbol on them. If you can see it there, it's a paintbrush, like a little golden paintbrush. And these are Faber-Castell, and I got them in a value shop. And they're really easy to get. They're not that expensive. I mean, under €5 we're talking. And it usually comes with a simple paintbrush and a sharpener. Like, they're not the highest quality, the paintbrush or the sharpener, but look, it definitely will get you started. So these watercolour pencils I have here are a mixture of the good value ones and then some more expensive ones that I have myself. Now, this is how I start everyone off. Now, normally I'd prefer people to be doing their own thing, but I'm just saying this now. This is a good way to get started for your first one. So take a normal pencil. Now, you may be comfortable doing this a few times. I'm just doing like an outline of a mountain. And now, this is again, it's very simple. I'm going to take all the earthy colours. I've got blue, brown, I've got brown, green. I'm even going to use a bit of purple. And we're going to put it under this line in it. Just lash it in, really. Don't worry. Don't be too delicate about it. Now, I have people I work with that do this very fastidiously and do a beautiful job, but I'm doing this quickly because we need to have it all done in under 10 minutes. Now I have a dark. So a rough rule of thumb is with landscape is that the darker objects or the darker things tend to be up close to the viewer, kind of at the bottom of the page or where the viewer is. Then as we go into the background, we tend to use lighter colours. I'm going to throw a bit of purple in. I'm going to throw a bit of brown in. I'm going to throw a bit of yellow in. And what I'm really doing is I'm putting down pigment. This is orange. So I'm getting pigment all over this page. And then we're going to add water, which will turn it all into watercolour. Even a bit of pink, a few blobs of pink. You see, everything kind of blends together. I know it looks very chaotic. And then I'm putting dark brown. Like I said, oops, I've lost my nib. These things happen. That's why we have our sharpener. Now these are my favourite sharpeners, the metal ones, if you see them. Okay. Now, I think that's good. Now, for the sky, I do the sky very simply. We don't want to cover the sky completely in blue, because that wouldn't be very realistic of Ireland. There's always a few clouds. So I'm just putting the blue on, and I'm leaving patches that will give us like a variation in the sky. Okay, that's all the pencil done. Now I'll get my brush. And you can see that just turns into beautiful watercolour. So I want to leave patches of white so that they appear like cloud. And if you work it with the brush backwards and forward, it takes away your pencil marks. Now, you may want to keep your pencil marks, and we'll see that later when we're doing the lower part of the landscape. But if you work it back and forth, it'll just obliterate them. And then where, I'm going to show you when we're finished the blue. When we're finished the areas that I want a, quite a strong blue, I'll go back over the white areas with just pure water, just so that at the moment there's quite a hard edge between the blue and the white, and I'll show you how to soften that. Now, any purist watercolour people looking at me, I'm really sorry, because this is watercolour the rough way. But it's a way of getting a nice result very quickly and just enjoy it. Of course, you could have, so you see how that's softened it up? And as it dries, look different again. And now so I've given my brush now. Can you see that? A good swish. And now I'm going to start on the green area. For me, I like to start with the lighter colours first, because with watercolour, you can cover the lighter colours, but you can't cover the darker colours really. So you have a bit more control that way. Now, doesn't that look a lot different? Now, of course, you could take a picture that you like and do your own version of it. Like, I just put this out of my head. It's completely made up. But you might find that an easy way to start. So I'm running my brush up and down like this, kind of to simulate grass, or just to take the boringness out of it. Yeah. There we go. So you can see as it dries, the colours kind of bleed into each other a bit, and you get these kind of random things that are actually really beautiful. Now, this is a bit wet. In an ideal world, I'd let it dry out completely before calling it finished. But I'm going to start taking the tape off, and you can see why we've done it. Kind of gives you makes it look a bit more finished, doesn't it? Where it comes away. And this is like painter's masking tape, like for house painting. It's really inexpensive. It's very easy to get as well. Sometimes it comes in a bluey colour, the masking tape does. So there we go, great. Now, I'm lucky to have one of these around, but you can buy these frames with the mounting already in them. In a lot of shops that are still open at the moment, and this is the frame for one of those. So you can imagine doing that, showing it in a frame, be a nice little gift for somebody. I'm going to take a close-up of this, and it'll be on the end of the video so you can have a proper look at it. So thank you so much for joining me in the little bit of painting, and give it a go, because it's good fun and you can't do any harm. Okay, God bless and stay safe. Bye bye.
So we've come to the end of the second video, and I really hope it's given you ideas for things to do, things to keep you occupied and enjoy during the week. Next week we're going to be looking at using an everyday object such as this, a sock. And Carmel is going to show us how to use socks to make glove puppets. I think it's going to be great fun. I hope you join us, and take care and have a good week and stay safe. Thank you. Bye.